Hello everybody, this is Roger Hansen. I'm back again with another video. This time it's going to be about my brother's PlayStation 3. He has a overheating problem, and I have been checking the YouTube videos and coming up with ways of fixing the solution. I've heard some people say that it's a manufacturing problem that they came out with PlayStation 3, and I start to believe that that's actually what it is. This is my second time around. The first time it was suggested that I put some cooling solution or some compound on the thermal areas right here. I did that already, cleaned it off with alcohol, and I put the compound on, and it was a temporary solution. It helped out for about 3 weeks. After that, the overheating problem came back, and we just didn't work with it until tonight. I went through and came up with another suggestion that I'm going to do. I've also heard some people talking about prying these up, and I might actually do that, but I'm not going to do it right now because to me that seems like the final solution. If it doesn't work, then that means there's actually nothing that can be done to help with this system. And besides that, I think that if you do this, you're pretty much insane, and either you're insane or you have no other choice but to do it, and that's why I'll do that with my RSX and this right here, my processor and stuff. But before I do that, I'm gonna do some another suggestion that I found out about tonight, and I thought it might work because I've done this with my laptop. And the suggestion that I got was here under the fan, right down underneath here. I don't know if you can see it, but I've drilled little bitty holes all through the bottom of the PlayStation's manifold, and that is right directly underneath the fan. Now, I've seen a couple guys on there on YouTube who said that that actually works, so I'm going to give it a try. And the only reason why I believe that it'll work is because I have an old Acer laptop that overheats. And what I did with that is I just took the cover off of the battery and I stuck a fan next to it, and it draws a lot of heat out from underneath there, and it prevents it from overheating. So I honestly believe that this would happen or work. I've also heard in some of the comment sections where people have said to take a fan and put it next to this and it'll help with overheating. And just to let everybody know, I've tried that and it does not work. For some odd reason, it doesn't pull heat, so maybe you need a real strong box fan or something to set next to it, or it just doesn't work, one or the other. So this is going to be what I'm going to try now. I'm going to put a thermal compound back on this, use alcohol to clean this off and to clean these off, and I've drilled holes underneath my fan. I'm gonna see if this works, and if it doesn't work, then later on I'll do this as my final solution to see if it helps. But like I said, I'm not gonna do that until I have to. Besides doing the holes in this, the bottom of this on my GPU and my CPU, I used rubbing alcohol to clean it. And I also used rubbing alcohol on my thermocouples to clean it and to get all this off. I was told, and I agree with this too, the best thing to use are these type of wash rags. Don't use ones that have cotton fibers on it or toilet paper. You can use toilet paper, but it's suggested to use these because you don't want to really have any contaminants on your CPU, your GPU, or your thermocouples to interrupt the connection between the compound. Now, what I'm gonna do now, after I've got these cleaned off and everything, I'm going to put my compound on, and the compound that I'm using is Quicksilver, I believe is what it's called. No, it's Arctic Circle. And a lot of people put a lot of thermal compound on their thermal couples, but I agree with one of the YouTubers that I watch on YouTube about this, and he does basically like I do with computer CPUs. You don't have to put too much on it, just put a dot in the middle, enough to where whenever the GPU and the CPU heat up, it spreads the compound out on it evenly. You don't have to overdo it. Last time I did it, I took this off and one of the thermocouples, the compound didn't go all the way out like I wanted it to, so I'll just add a little bit more. But that's one suggestion that I really do believe in, because I know that's true. Now, with the thermocouples, you have little pug, you have little pugs, like little poking up spots right here where these thermocouples will fit perfectly into it. Then the grooves, basically, and you sit it down like this, perfectly there, and you take this one and you set it right there in beside it. My PlayStation, it has these little insulation things here. I didn't put them there. They came in whenever we got the PlayStation 3. So I've heard other people say that it actually does help out. I don't know for sure if it does or not, but just so you guys know, because you can see it on there. Some people do have them in there, some people don't. But the whole thing is you gotta get these thermocouples into that thermal, or into those grooves. When they fit like that, you take that, and you leave it like that, then you take your fan, and you fit your fan in. Now see, I have these holes underneath right here. When I set the fan in, it will fit directly over the top of those holes, so that whenever that fan needs extra air, it'll be able to draw air from underneath there. Hopefully that'll work out. The guy that I got that idea from, that he actually put filters in there too to filter it out, and he also did it on the front part where they have the vents here too. So I'm not going to do that, but if I have to, I'll end up doing it. Here on this corner, and over here, there's four little screws that you need to put in to tighten all this together. And once you get that done, you move on to your shield. And put this on. Now, what we do is we put this shield on over the top. This right here, and this goes over your thermocouples, and your motherboard will go on top of it with your GPU and your CPU over the top of it. This is when we put the thermal glue on this area right here. Do not put it on your GPU or your CPU, put it on your thermocouples, and when you do, only put about a pea size worth of thermal compound on it. Don't overdo it. Okay, like I was saying, if you use more than a pea size amount of compound, you're pretty much wasting good compound. Also, with the holes on the bottom, I also want to mention that I used a rotary toolkit, which I'm aware that most people don't have that. I also want to say that's not a problem, because I've seen a YouTuber on YouTube that showed a pretty cool trick that I did like. I just didn't choose to do it the way he did. He took a can and he heated the bottom of it up, and he just pressed it on the backside of the PlayStation and did it over and over again until it created a hole. And I know it sounds like it probably looked awful, but it didn't. It actually looked pretty cool. He's talking about decorating it with a screen or something on the back of it, because he didn't want, you know, little kids to touch it or something like that and hurt their finger, which makes sense. But to me, it looked pretty good. On this, whenever I drilled the holes, I had plastic that was poking through. And I'm not really worried about, you know, appearance of how this is PlayStation's going to look. I just want it to work. So what I did is I took my rotary toolkit and I put the sander adapter on it, and I started sanding the back and taking the plastic off of it. And it doesn't look all that great, but it's smooth and the holes are actually opened up, you know. So either way, like I said, just the important thing is getting the holes in it. It doesn't matter if there's little holes or if you can put some kind of hole back there for the fan to breathe, but that's the important thing. Now I've got to get a stand to lift it up to where it can actually breathe down there, or I'm going to have to start sitting this up on the side. But like I said, just a pea size of your thermal compound is all you need. Don't overdo it, because if you do, you're wasting good content. Now, I also want to apologize too, because I said earlier that you will want to use thermal compound on the thermocouples, and I messed up. I got that backwards. You want to put it on the chips. Put it on the chips, don't put it on the thermocouple. That's something that I wanted to clear up. I realized I said that earlier, so I got back on here and I decided to clear that up real quick.